Okay, so I'd like to summarize the discussion that we had about Tryton documentation. Of course, it was as controversial as all the debates we have had till today on the topic. So we divided the group into producing the three different documents that are required. One is a user guide, also known as a functional guide. The other, from a developer perspective, guidelines, cheat sheets on how to develop, probably more on the concept, explaining the concept with examples, the hello world, and all those from one direction. And installation and configuration guide for the system admin kind of person who is going to take care of your Tryton installation. So these are the three kind of documents that we want to produce, and there was a little heated debate on how exactly what tool do we use for maintaining this documentation and how do we generate the documentation if we have to auto-generate it. So one of the conclusions that we had was the user guide or is going to be contributed by new users who come in or end users who may not have the requisite technical knowledge. So probably we should try and have a wiki kind of thing like what New Health has, where it's easier for people to come in and contribute. And as for the developer guide, we have a pretty good generated documentation from the Tryton core itself, which we could further extend on with code examples. Then we have the API reference, which was generated by Udo's code. We could continue to use that. And for the modules, we could use the upcoming module being built by Nantic and probably use the demo database that Tryton uses, or a database with all the modules installed, so that it's a complete extensive documentation which gets generated from there. So that is outside of the user guide, which is a user contributed tips and tricks. And finally, the installation and configuration guide, kind of giving in the best practices on how to set it up and how to monitor the application and so on. So for now, we have put up a repository on GitHub because it's kind of the easiest thing to edit. I know Cedric doesn't agree to that. So you can check out the documentation on tryton-documentation.readthedocs.org. So you can go there. We have put in dummy pages. We already have two contributors who are going to send in patches right away. So as you browse, okay, hold on. Okay, there we go. So you will see a small widget kind of thing. I hope everybody can see that. It's right at the bottom of the screen.
You're in the middle, I think.
Yeah, I am. So it opens up when you click on that black thing or brown thing. It shows a pop-up window. You can click on edit, and this page, this repository would be forked for you if you have a GitHub account, and you can edit it right there. The syntax used is RST, so that in future when we move out, it's a standard Python formatting. So you have to learn it anyway. I think it's a good value addition. So you can edit it and you can send a pull request back. And we could probably have the same kind of review and support system that we have. More advanced users, they could just, it's a basic Spring documentation. So you could just clone the repository, fork the repository, make your changes, add whatever you want to, and send it back. Now, in this case, I think I'll just add installation procedure. Let's just try and edit this just as an example. So this opens a page for you. You can hit edit again. The project is forked when you commit. So preparing application servers, preparing basic database configuration. Okay, I think it's safe to say that Postgres is the recommended. Tryton. So I can just put in a message here.
Very good message.
Okay, and I can propose the file change. What it automatically does is it commits this and it also creates a pull request to the maintainer. And you can just send a pull request. With this, it's done. Now it's up to the maintainers of the package. Oh, that's not me. The maintainers of the package can decide, of this documentation, maybe we can create a pool of users who would review that and decide whether this is the right contribution. It's very easy to see the changes on GitHub because it gives you a diff. If there are images, it shows you the difference of the images, if there are new images that are uploaded. So it's right here. And I guess I have to be me again. I don't know, I will log out from here. Everybody, please close your eyes. Okay, and
really no master password.
There is one. Okay, so I have. Okay, there's one more pull request sent 7 minutes ago, so I can check the. Postgres is a recommended server. I can merge the pull request, and every time we merge this, this documentation that's there, what I showed you before, it's automatically built. It's on read the docs, so the documentation always remains up to date. Now, second thing what we got to figure out on this is translations. So there is a multilingual support for strings, and read the docs also supports it. So if volunteers come forward and translate some of the strings that are there, I feel we could have a really multilingual documentation for it. Also, another cool feature, it's more or less a GitHub feature, but I think it's pretty cool. Now, since this is a patch he sent, I'm sure I'm not happy with this. So I could comment over right here. Tryton is a wonderful platform to work with. Populated with equally wonderful modules and people. Okay, fine, what went wrong, fine, white went wrong. Okay, I don't think I can find mistakes on this one. Cedric, do you want to try?
Thank you, Sharon.
Okay, maybe not. So if I have comments, I can even write comments right here, so probably he can fix the changes once again, send it back. So we are not going to be as rigid as Cedric is, so please feel free to send your whatever little changes that you have, we'll be happy to merge. Any questions, suggestions, ideas?
Can I just propose our workshop from tomorrow?
That would be great.
Yeah.
I think that would be great. And probably someone who is very familiar with REST could even just give
up.
So we have a volunteer, right? So I think we can have a session tomorrow on documentation.
I have to don't remember all the features of anything, but I will do it. Would you like to write the homework today tonight?
Something I forgot to mention, you can see a preview of your REST code right there when you edit it. So GitHub allows you to preview it before you send it. So I think that will be pretty handy.
Okay.
Okay. I think we should have some content first. Once we have some content, I think we can discuss how we can clean from the main website. Okay. Thanks, everybody.